Yeah, hey, how's it going? This is Rob Thomas calling in.
I have never been more excited in my whole freaking life. Oh, my gosh.
Oh, this you is... should get out more.
I really should.
let me just preface this whole interview process, Rob. Can I call you Rob?
Yeah, of course. That would be appropriate since it's my name.
Well, my name is Bobby, and I go by Bobby. You go by Rob, so we're kind of kindred spirits here. But my partner Liberty is one of your biggest fans, and her life's goal has been to meet you and talk to you. So this right now is a really, really big deal for her.
Hi, Liberty. How you doing?
Don't even know right now.
That's so funny.
Wow. Okay. Yep.
All right, Liv.
Happening.
Yeah.
How's it going, guys?
It's going great.
We're doing really well. How are you, sir?
I'm doing well.
So I feel like I should break the ice and just let you go ahead and talk about Sidewalk Angels for a little bit. I talk about it a lot on the show because we do a lot with local rescue here in Evansville, and we just think the work that you and your wife are doing is amazing.
Oh, I appreciate that. We're really proud of it. I mean, over the years, you know, something that it started really small and grassroots, and it's something that we wanted to keep that way because we like it so that all the donations can go directly to any, you know, of the other organizations that we support. So now, you know, we've raised millions, and we've done it with just basically, you know, me and my mother-in-law and my mom and my staff and my management kind of pitching in and helping out. And now we've partnered up with the Humane Society of the United States, and we just have participated with the Sato Project in one of the biggest rescues of all time. We rescued like 247 dogs from Puerto Rico. We just got one giant commercial airliner and loaded a bunch of dogs on it.
We are talking with Rob Thomas, and folks can still buy tickets to see you next week in Louisville, right?
Yeah, I'm excited about it. We've been on the road. We just started the second leg of this tour that we've been out on, and I mean, I don't think the band, you know, this solo band I've had, it's the same solo band that I've had since 2005. So it's like going back and forth between Matchbox and this other family.
And I've already seen one of the shows. I was actually at the Nashville show. So that was pretty awesome. Just say that.
Wasn't that a beautiful venue?
It was. And I mean, coming back to the Palace, actually, the first time I saw you with Matchbox was at the Palace. And that is a beautiful, amazing, it sounds great in there. And it's just art inside of it.
Yeah, I love that. We just played in Pittsburgh in an old theater there that's really beautiful like that. This whole tour has been like, you know, we ended the last show in an arena in Connecticut, and then we did a lot of outdoor kind of shed venues, and then a lot of like old theaters. It's kind of nice because we know it's not the same venue over and over. We never know what we're going to wake up to.
So do you prefer to play like a large stadium or more the intimate kind of performance, kind of like the Ryman?
You know, I don't know. I mean, we've had times where we've played, you know, like we played the Forum to like 15, 20,000 people, and it's amazing. But then we've also played, you know, the other night at the Capitol Theater, which is probably like 1,200 people in Portchester, New York, and it felt magical. So I just think it's all about the night. You know what I mean? Like just some nights you pull into a giant venue and you think, well, this is going to be awesome. And for some reason, all the stars just don't align. And I think there's just something kind of magic about when everybody that came to see the show and everybody that came to perform a show is all kind of on the same page and just wants to kind of let loose and celebrate life for a minute.
And I think kind of, I don't know if you realize this or not, I feel like this new album is kind of almost has a country feel to it.
I think most of my songs could probably be country songs.
That's true, yeah.
You know, like if you say even Lonely No More, I imagine if you produced it differently. Like, I think, you know, it's all about, because everything gets started with the guitar or the piano. Everything is some sort of a story you're trying to tell. I think there's a lot of roots in old country, especially because I grew up in South Carolina. So when I was young, like, all I ever listened to was Willie Nelson and Waylon Jennings and Conway Twitty and just a bunch of old country. And then when I was a teenager, it was all like that second British invasion and bands like The Cure and New Order and things like that. So I think somewhere in between all of those different kinds of styles is wherever I'm at.
Talking with Rob Thomas, whose Chip Tooth Tour continues next week at the Palace in Louisville, Kentucky on Wednesday, September 4th. Liberty will be there. Rob, if you don't mind, I'm going to ask you a question that we got from one of our listeners. We put out a request earlier this morning for people to submit questions for us to ask you. So this question is from Tasha, and she would like to know that if you never became a musician, what do you think that you would be doing right now instead of music?
You know, honestly, I think that I would just be doing this just less successfully.
Like, right on.
Like, I don't really have any other life skills, you know, like it's an amazing thing. Like, if you see me in my element, it's like Eddie Murphy at the beginning of Coming to America, you know, like I'm exactly where I'm supposed to be. You know, I look like a fortuitous, successful musician. And then, but if you put me, you know, like under the hood of a car, I'm like Eddie Murphy when he goes to Queens and Coming to America, and I'm completely out of my element, and I look like an idiot.
So you'd be a starving artist instead of a very successful artist.
Yeah. I mean, I was all in. Like, at some point, I think you wind up having to be all in. And as you get older, you know, you let other viable career opportunities go by, you know, let these ground floor opportunities and college and a lot of these things. And so it's funny, if you flash forward, it's a very thin line, I think, between being a tenacious, successful musician who stuck with it. And you can say, well, you know, you can look at it and say, well, of course this worked out this way, but it's a fine line between that and me being 47 years old and sleeping on my friend's couch while I'm still waiting for my band to take off.
Now, I know I've heard you say in other interviews that you do not want to hear Smooth on the radio ever again. You didn't care if you ever heard it again, but you still play it. Is there a song that you love hearing on the radio?
Not of mine. I think, you know, it's just something like you're so completely personal. And I think playing them every night, it's new, and it has a new energy every night. But when I listen to an old recording of myself or Matchbox or any of that stuff, I think all we're hearing is like a time capsule of production things that we might have done differently. Because now, you know, we play them live, it has a different vibrance to it. But once you record it, it's kind of there forever. So when it first comes out and we finish a record, you listen to it all the time. You listen to it in the car, you listen to it in different stereos, you listen to it at your friend's house. And then after a while, you just get sick of it, and then you love to play it. You just don't really like hearing yourself anymore.
So, Rob, you've mentioned a couple times so far, you've referenced Matchbox 20, and I don't know if this is a taboo subject, if I'm all right to ask this, so forgive my ignorance, but what are the odds of you and Matchbox 20 getting back together and doing some new stuff for us?
Screw those guys, man. No,
Man, I'm doing just fine on my own, man.
No, we're actually going out next summer. And doing it, and we're gonna do a tour for a few months next summer, and then use that opportunity to kind of get together and maybe start writing some new music for the next year.
Oh, that's
because
so
it's
amazing.
2020. Get it? See?
I see.
Right. We have to tour because so last year we toured because it was the 20th anniversary of our first record. Next year is 2020, and it's the 20th anniversary of our second record.
So I've seen you many times in concert. Loved every show. I think my favorite thing, though, is when you tell stories about the songs, because I'm like, that's, you know, something you can't get anywhere else, and every show's unique and different. And I try to tell the stories verbatim to other people, like, I'll come in and tell Bobby, oh my gosh, you got to hear the story about the song. But could you tell everybody the story about how you wrote the song Little Wonders?
Oh, Little Wonders, I wrote just because I was, I'd been tapped by Disney to write a song for this movie, and then I wound up going to Phoenix. I was at Matchbox in Phoenix, and I was, after the show, I had to walk my dog out in the rain, and I was really upset about it. And then I looked down, and my dog was so unbelievably happy. And I kind of realized that there was this moment that I was missing out on, and now he's passed away, and I think I would do anything to get that moment back. And it kind of made me think about all these times that we spend in our life kind of thinking about something in the past or thinking about something that's about to happen. And we're not really in the moment. You're not really appreciating the moment that you're in. And that moment's never going to last the way it is right then. And so then Little Wonders just kind of sprang immediately right after that.
Rob Thomas, the Chiptooth Tour, September 4th in Louisville at the Palace. Man, this has been awesome. I personally really appreciate it. And I can't convey enough how much you have made Liberty's day and life.
Yes.
So you're coming out to that show too, Liberty?
I will be at the show in Louisville. I've reached out to several different people that work for you, I guess, and they've all told me I can't get in the meet and greet. I'm not sure what's... I'm even a fan club member. Like, I paid for a fan club membership.
Who's the radio rep?
I've been talking with Daria.
Daria?
Yeah.
Okay, you guys have recorded this. Tell Daria that I said that it's totally fine, that you should come by in the meet and greet and say hi.
Okay.
Oh, were we supposed to be recording this? Oh, my bad.
If I had Daria in my cell phone, I would call her myself. But you have this recorded, so take this little piece. Daria, please let Liberty come to the meet and greet.
Oh, my gosh. Liberty is a puddle on the floor right now, Rob.
I'm going to go cry somewhere now in a hole.
Man, we really do appreciate the time. It's been great talking to you.
Cool. Thank you, brother. I really appreciate your help. Thanks.
All right.
Thank you.
All right. I'll see you then, Liberty.
See you Wednesday. Bye.